So in the normal course of cleaning it, you would run a vacuum over it, one presumes.
Mm-hmm.
So I know with some carpets, if you use the beater function on your vacuum, you can end up pulling up the fibers and making it, you know, over the years very thin. So how would you vacuum, or would you even vacuum one of these rugs?
But the thing is, I won't vacuum these rugs crazy. I would vacuum it, I would say, maybe once or twice a month, because nothing happens to these rugs. If you are even using them a lot, I have in my living room, which is my, not my formal living room, my dining room, which is not my formal dining room, we eat food, and I have a 10-year-old who tends to spill things, and I still don't clean the rug every day. So what I do is I kind of clean it, you know, maybe, because it's used so much, I would say once a week. So it'll help you with a wool rug, as you said, it's so resilient that it'll stay good. So don't vacuum it too much.
And when you vacuum, should you turn the beater bar off so you don't have that spinning action, it just has suction, or does it make a difference?
It does not make a difference, I would say. You can use beater bar if you want. If you don't like to and you're scared, don't use it. If it's dirty, I do use beater bar, and I use it for if I think it doesn't need it, I don't. I just suck it, kind of a thing. But I tend not to use a lot of vacuum on my rugs, just because it's better not to use too much. If you just use it, if you think it's like a carpet and you're just using it 3 times a day, it doesn't make sense. Honestly, you do not need to vacuum your rugs like crazy.
And what about, you said food going on it. I mean, what's the best way to get, not a stain per se, but let's say, you know, the kid dropped something on there, and how would you wipe up or get rid of any?
I would, like, you know, use, like, instead of beater, I would just either use a broom to take off that, or I would also use, like, instead of the beater, the vacuum section, yeah.
And then would you wipe it with cold water, warm water? How would
I would I would say moderate water. I would clean it up with the moderate water, and it goes away.
Mm.
I also like to clean it. I like my rugs, instead of vacuuming too much, I like to have them professionally cleaned once a year.
And they come into your house to
do
that?
They come into my house and do that. And the best thing to do is when somebody comes into your house and then they do that, I would say to them, do the cleaning, just like the little bit of here, mm-hmm. just clean it a little bit here, just the corner of the rug. I want you to clean the corner of the rug, and then after like 5 minutes I see there's nothing happened, then I say, okay, now you can actually clean the whole rug, because I want to just make sure that they're not using some kind of you know, things that are going to be harmful for the rug. So it's better just to use the corner. And if they use the corner, I've had when I got married 26 years ago, my dad gave me those rugs. I still have them. They're still, you know, they're still the way they are. But the thing is I don't vacuum them like crazy, and I have them professionally cleaned once a year. But when I'm doing them, I make sure that they are cleaning little part of it
first to check.
On the back also, I have them, if it's an expensive 1616, I'm like, okay, let's clean the back of it first. If something happens, it's going to just cover the back and not see the front, so you can tell. And I have used 2-3 different guys who come in and clean. It turns out to be fine. A lot of people ask me how much, you know, is how much should you pay? Again, it depends on where you are, you know. So it depends on a size of the rug.
I was going to say, surely it depends also on how big, you know,
big the rug is.
It's like washing cleaning the carpets in a 5-bedroom house or a 1-bedroom house. It's
different. Yeah. So I would say it depends on the size. But normally they charge between $2 to $4 per square foot. That's their standard if they're going to come in and clean the rugs for you.
And is there anything in particular, so if you were going to, I mean, there's like companies that come in and they wet shampoo, there are some who come in and they steam shampoo, and so, I mean, is there any in particular that you would say definitely do not?
I do. I have done the shampooing, and I have done the what was the other one?
Steaming.
I've done both,
and they've been fine.
They have been fine. The only thing I do different is I actually like to put, once they do it, I like to put the rug outside for an hour or 2 hours in the sun, just because, you know, they're a little bit damp and I don't want any kind of smell coming out of them. I just do it. Mm. And I try not to use it while they're damp. But nothing happens. Both the way is fine. I would say the only thing I say to the guys who come over is, if you can use less of the chemicals and use more of vinegar and water and just natural stuff, it'll be better for me. So that's what I tell them. But again, it depends on different people. And they have done, a lot of times when people come in, they have done it so much, they're extra careful. They know the rugs, they know the pricing. So they're extra careful with that also.